Hello children, I am your science mom speaking. Now we are going to see lesson number 5, what's the matter? So this is going to be a new topic for you children. In this lesson, we will be able to explore the properties of different states of matter. They are solid, liquid and gas. And we will be able to learn about the changes between the different states of matter. So the big question of this lesson is, why do things around me appear different from one another? So by the end of this lesson, you will get a clear idea about the things around us is made up of what. So what are the things you are seeing around? Whether it is different from one another or not. Some may be hard, some may be soft, some may be different in size, their color, taste, smell, etc. Now, in detail, we can see about the different types of things present around us. Here, we have the PEP activity. We use our sense organs to observe and learn about the world around us. In this activity, we will use them to compare and discuss the features of some common foods. For this, you need one cookie, one piece of apple, one cup of lemon juice, and two paper cups. Now let us discuss this activity using these things. Now read the features of the cookie, the apple and the lemon juice listed. Now we can discuss and write the observation of these food in the respective columns. We are going to discuss the features of these things, their shape, color, hardness, smell, taste. Now let us see. The shape of the cookie is round. Apple is round or crescent shape. Lemon juice, it is not having any shape and it takes the shape of the cup. Color. The cookie color is light brown or dark brown or orange in color. Apple, either it may be red, green, cream or light brown. For lemon juice, it is yellow or white or it does not have any color. For the hardness, cookie is hard, apple is also hard and lemon juice is not hard. Smell. Cookie is chocolate or sweet smell. Apple is fruity or sweet or sour smell. Lemon juice has lemon smell. Taste. The cookie is sweet or salty in taste. Apple is sweet or sour in taste. The lemon is sour in taste. So other than this, we can write any other feature also. Break. Now let us check whether these things can be break or not. Yes, of course, cookies can cut. Apple also can be cut. But lemon juice, we can't cut. It can be poured. Now let us write the answer for these questions. Next, try to cut the cookie, apple and lemon juice. Which of them could you cut? Yes, of course, we discussed previous, the cookie and the apple can be cut. Now, we need to try to pour each of them from one cup to another. Which of these foods flowed from one cup to another? Yes, of course, exactly, only the lemon juice can be poured. Now, let us discuss three questions given here. The first question is, among the three foods that we observed, which two do you think are similar to each other? The second question is, how are these foods similar to each other? Third question, how is the third food different from these two things? Now, for the first question, if you were selecting the answer cookie and apple, for the second one, you can write both are hard and sweet. And the fourth, and for the third one, lemon juice cannot cut, can be poured or sour in taste. Suppose for the first question, if you are selecting the answer apple and lemon juice, for the second one, you can write both are sour in taste. And for the third one, you can write cookie is sweet. At last, suppose if you are selecting the answer cookie and lemon juice, for the second question, you can write as both are salty. And for the third one, you can write apple is sweet. So any one of the answer you can select by your wish. So things around us vary in color, shape, size, and the way they feel to touch. Such features of a thing are known as properties. So all the things have properties that help us to identify and describe them. The key question is, what are things made up of? Now let us discuss what are the things made up of. So based on their properties, things can be solids, liquids, or gases. Now let us explore and understand the unique properties of each of these in detail. For this, we are going to perform an activity. We need one small wooden stick, a glass of water, one paper cup, one empty plastic bottle, one plastic bowl, three balloons of different shapes. And here, the glass of water, one paper cup, empty plastic bottle and bowl, all these things are mentioned as containers. The first what we have to do is arrange the containers on a table. Second, as you perform each step in the activity, now we have to record what are the questions given below. The steps to be followed are, now we need to place the stick in each of the container and we have to observe any changes in the shape of the stick has happened. For this, the observation is, the shape of the stick does not change when it is placed in different containers. Next, we can try to pour the stick from one container to another container. Whether it is possible? No, of course. The stick did not flow when poured from one container to another container. As the stick is a solid, it can't be poured. Now C. In C option, pour the water into each of the container. Now let us observe what happens. The water flowed when poured from one container to the another. Your D option, look for any change in the shape of the water each time. So the shape of the water changes when poured into different containers. It means that water is not having any specific shape. It takes the shape of the container. Now E option, take all the three balloons, blow air into two balloons. Then you can draw the shape of the balloons filled with air in the space provided. So after blowing the balloon, what you have observed? Yes, the shape of the air in the two balloon is not the same. As the shape of the balloon is different, the size is also different. Next, try to pour the air filled in one of these balloon into the empty balloon, can we pour the air from one balloon to another? No, it is not possible. So the observation tells that the air did not flow when poured from one balloon to another. So till this part of this lesson is over. Let's meet in the next part. Thank you, children.